In the previous tutorial, I explained the component of our roof floor plan general arrangement. In this tutorial, we will go into our objective will be to duplicate the first floor general arrangement drawing. I'm not going to select it now. We need to first delete our structural grid and column. So I've selected the grid. Remember, I always deselect this column at this region because I want to use it as my reference to duplicate the copied first floor plan general arrangement. So I'll hit delete to remove the grid and the columns. So now I'll select the first floor plan general arrangement. I'll unselect the heading because I don't want that copied, duplicated. I also unselect the column because I don't want the column duplicated. I will click copy on my ribbon. Using this as my base point, I will duplicate at this location. Oh, I didn't do it properly. Sorry, I will undo. At this point. So the roof floor plan general arrangement is shown on the screen. I told you, so let's start making our edit. We'll start with the structural element at grid line A. I told you we have three components. Right now, we really have the structural work component, which is denoted with a W1 label. So I'm going to use rectangular. Apart from this structural element, we'll have a 230 column here and a 230 by 190 column here. As shown in this drawing, a 230 by 190 column at grid line A1 and a 230 by 230 column at grid line A. So I'll use my rectangular tool to draw a 230 by 230 column. I'll draw a 230 by 190 column at grid line A1. I would like to denote these two columns. Let's denote it with a red column since they are also vertical support members. So I'll apply this color using the mesh property to my two columns I just drew. I'll apply it here. So I will copy these two columns to grid line 2, grid line 3, grid line 4, grid line 5, grid line 6, grid line 7. So I'll give our last column label on this drawing is C5. So I'm going to C5. So I'll tag this C6. I'll select and copy it to the top, upward. I'll tag this C7. So this is C6 column here, C7 column here. So I'm also going to select and duplicate the tags at the other grid location. So C6 and C7. So we need to update our column wall type schedule. I'm going to select this cell. I will click on insert below. Again, insert below. So 7, we have C6. We have 230 by 230 column. How many number? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 number. Or C6 column at 8. We have C7 We have 230 by 190 column, 7 number of columns too. So we're adding 14 columns to the total, making 41. Our total is 41 number of column at the roof floor level. But remember that I want to, this C3 does not exist at the roof floor level. I told you, I think in my previous tutorial, so I'm going to delete the C3 column label and the C3 column. I'm going to, I also delete this line. I'll extend this to this column. Extend this to this column. Extend it to this column. I'll delete this beam. I don't want it in my drawing. So now we only have one panel there. I'm going to delete this slab information here. So, and I'll move this a bit to the center of the panel. So I need to delete the update my column or type schedule again and remove the C3 column. So I'm going to delete that role. I'm going to delete that role now. I've deleted that role. I've deleted the C3 column. So I will update my serial number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now I'm going to draw my beams at along the line A1 for this drawing. I'll copy this line, select this line, copy to this point and this point, my beam at that region, connecting the two columns. I'm going to duplicate, select and duplicate these two lines for the other locations. I moved it instead. Copy. Sorry. I want to put this panel arrow. We have a slab at this region, in this region where my cursor is hovering on. We have a slab at this region too. We have here, a slab simply supported between the line A and A1. So I'm going to provide the slab information, the one way simply supported slab. I will copy this panel arrow. I will place it here. I need to make the arrow smaller, so I'm editing it already. I'll move this corner inward. Move it. So this is our spanning arrow for this panel. Our thickness label, I'm going to also position it there. However, the circle is too big. I want to reduce the size. Label, the thickness of the slab is 150. I'll make the circle, no. I'll reduce the size of the text. I click on this, select the cell, right click your mouse, property, change the text height to say 150. So it's okay like this. Before I also supply the elevation detail for this slab, I'm going to correct the elevation detail for the other panels first. I will not provide elevation label for this panel because the slab slopes and does not have a single elevation value. So I'm going to delete, select all the elevation label, and I will delete them. Let me leave this one. I'm going to select the elevation levels and delete this one. I will move it to my slab panel for the roof gutter. Move. The text height, I'll change it to 150. Move it downward. The elevation of this slab, I told you that, let me zoom this way. This is the top of the slab. I use the measure command. It is at 600 from the top of the roof. So we need to deduct 600 from the elevation of the roof, which is 18 plus 425. I'll use my calculator on my laptop to do the simple math. 18425 minus 600. So 17825. This is 17825. Extend this box side to fit. Now I'll move all these elevation tags. I'll move it, say, to the center of the panel. This is the slab here is a panel from grid line between grid line A1 and 17. When we have a drop in slab, in our suspended slab, we can denote the drop, which I'll call recess, by a diagonal line. So in a drawing where you see diagonal line between a panel, it shows that the slab elevation has been changed on that suspended slab. So the elevation I'm going to use in my structural model for this roof plan is 18 plus 425. However, I'm going to drop my slab 600 mm down. So, and this line is denoting the drop. I'm going to change the color of the line to a blue color so it will flow with my slab. Change it to a blue color. So I'm done with specifying my roof gutter on my roof floor plan. So what I need to do, remember the beam, the depth of the beam at grid line A. For my proposed roof gutter, I told you that this, the 230 wall here represents my beam element at grid line A. So this depth is 750. So I'm going to change the value of this beam label to 750. Okay, this 230 by 600. Okay, 230 by 600. 230 by 600. 230 by 600, 230 by 600. This is also 230 by 600. Okay, 230 by 600. With the staircase, there is not any staircase at this level. The whole roof is covered with a flat roof. Yeah, it's covered with concrete. The whole roof is covered with concrete. So I'm going to delete the staircase objects at this region. Select and delete. And I will apply hidden details to hidden line property to this component. Let me apply the match property again. Didn't know why it did not apply the first time I applied it. So this is an internal beam. Same thing here, I'll delete the staircase component. In my roof plan, I want to provide a beam at this edge. So I'm going to copy all this line inward by 230 to denote the beam. Copy 230 inward. I'll apply hidden line property to the inner line of the beam. So I'm applying the hidden line property now. I want The beam label here is showing 230 by 450. I want my roof beam to be 230 by 600. This label here denotes the depth, the dimension of the beam along the line too. So I don't need to place a beam label here. I also delete this one, 450. I'll change this one to 230 by 600. Change this one to 230 by 600. 230 by 600. I don't need to provide a label here. I'll remove this. This one I'll change it to 230 by 600. The inner portion of this beam here will apply hidden line property to the inner to this line and this line. So I'm going to apply in the hidden line property now to the beams. Do the same thing here. Okay, I think I've worked on everything. Everything looks okay now. Now I've come to the end of this tutorial session. We have successfully denoted our information on the roof floor plan gear arrangement drawing. Our next session, we're going to draw section AA and section BB. Section AA will show the profile of the roof along the slope direction. I'm going to show you how we're going to draw the roof plan in section. Thank you for watching this video.